I come to put the hinges on here for that to move, I just want to make sure that everything fits into place. And also got to work on this in position, get it in the right position, trace round it, and then leave. Well, I'll show you. I'm coming 75 millimeters on the bottom, and center, I'm going to take it that way. 25, so it's a little bit more one way than the other, it's not quite centre, but it gives a good focus for the difference. Well, when I've come to think of it now, I'll make it a little bit more. Try and make it a little bit more centre, but it's 125 that way. 320 it wants to be about a mil difference. So it's 25 and 26. 25, somewhere near level. Right, so we can slowly trace around there with pencil. See clearly through into the attic. Okay, like that. That's what I'm doing. And I put that overnight to straighten out. And these got to join this together. You've got to join together. And we can hook it all up, hinge it all together. So what I'm going to do now is to file all these out. The lines. See? Work to the inner line. You've done that, see you've got plenty of clearance, you've still got your gauge lines, but as you can see, you can see straight through, no excess balsa wood in the way. So you've got a free clear to look into the clear view, to look into the attic, and you do the same with the other one. I stuck the supports on this round last night. The tip they give you when you put the glue on, hold it down with pegs, it keeps it quite secure. And that's what I've done. Let it dry over for the night. There's the job loving sound. Straight. Stay pretty straight. And the same again with this one. Put it on the front. Put this one on. All this excess work to the inner line. Take all that out. Got a clear view again. Okay. Start by taking a lot out of here. So. Finishing the last one, second one, maybe. Axis to see both sides. Okay. Ready for fitting now. That's how the roof should fit with the hinges. So my next job is now to hinge it up and hope we can fit it as it is there. But these two, I've got to stick these two together before we do that. And I can work on other little things. Well, these need finishing off by painting while that's drying. Well, I've stuck the two sides together. So I've got to leave them now for about a good 3 or 4 hours. Put that on just to keep it, stop it from bending up. So I'll put a bit of weight on there and what we can do now, I can start painting these, finishing these off. It's all taped up, needs a good paint all around. I'm ready when we put the hinges on, we just place them on top and the roof's nearly finished then. Right, when glued together, it's dry. Kept the tape on for now because it's a little bit loose, and put a bit more glue on the end. But when it's dry, what I've done, I've put some wood filler in the top and then just smoothed it over so it's got a nice clean fillet. Put the wood filler in there, let it dry, smooth it over so it's got a nice point at the top of the feet. That finished it off nice. Now I'm going to paint that one. and it will be ready to go on top. First of all, when that's screwed, then we've got to put the hinges on the main part of the roof. So I'm going to paint this one now. Just ready to put the hinge on there. It says 11 centimetres on the edge. I've marked the line and put the hinges on, and then use a bradawl just to mark out the lines, and there it is. There they are. There. The bradawl. Get it started. The screw. Two. Small screws. So it might be wise just to start it off. Get them screwing in first. Give each one a go first. Going in quite nicely, like this, so that can come out. One. Going in well as well. Two, just make the start. That's nice, going in nice slowly. So, stick the hinge back up. First hole, there she is. Tell her what I'll do. I'll stick a bit of tape on the hinge just to hold it in place. Got some in the leans a long way around. According to the picture, anyway. That one. Please like the video and subscribe to the video channel.